Cnidaria. The name Cnidaria comes from a Greek word nidos, which means stinging nettle. Casually touching many cnidarians will make it clear how they got their name when the nemocyst eject barbed threads tipped with poison.
The three major classes are Hydrozoa, Anthozoa, and Scyphozoa.
Hydrozoa! A pneumatophore is a gas-filled sac serving as a float in some colonial marine hydrozoans. It's at the very top of our hydrozoa. It's like the crown. And then there's a nectophore. It's a swimming bell of a siphonophore. It is below the pneumatophore and is attached to the stem. We can get to later. Right now. The stem transports nutrients to the nectophore. It is like the spine of the plant. And then there's the bract, which is a specialized leaf-like part, usually at the bottom of a plant. And then after the bract is the palpon with filiform pentacle. It's a cormineal element, probably a reduced gastrozoa, which may have sensitive or excretory functions. Then there's the gastrozoid, which is responsible for feeding. It feeds our hydrozoid, which is under the palpon, the filiform tentacle. Then under that is the tentaculae. They are side branches of the tentacle. And then we get to the tentacle of gastrozoid. It is a filiform tentacle which serves as a defensive zoid. It is what the tentaculae are attached to. And then finally we get to the medusoid gonophore. It's like a medusa having the fundamental structure of a medusa, but without the locomotive disc.
The next class we get to is class Anthozoa. Class Anthozoa contains the tentacle. The tentacle is the top structure of this polyp. It is covered with nematocytes and are stinging organs. It stings, so it will hurt if you touch it, so don't touch it. Underneath the tentacle is the mouth. The mouth is responsible for consuming food. It's underneath the tentacle and right above the mesenteral filaments. We'll get to mesenteral filaments right about now. The mesenteral filaments are string-like filaments. They are responsible for holding up the body structure of the polyp. After the mesenteral filaments, we get to the gastrovascular cavity. The gastrovascular cavity is where the mouth opens into lined with layers of cells called the gastrodermis. It's right below the mesenteral filaments and right above the gonad. The gonad is a sex gland where gametes are produced, ovary or testes, also known as. Underneath the gonads is the calcium carbonate skeleton. The calcium carbonate skeleton is also responsible for supporting the polyp structure. After that is the gastrodermal. The gastrodermal tube is also known as the selenia. The gastrodermal tube, or the selenia, is where the polyp attaches to its growing surface. And those folks are our
Scyphozoa, the jellyfish. The mesoglia is a jelly-like substance that separates the epidermis from the gastrodermis. That's the little jelly part inside.
The epidermis covers the external body surface.
That's the skin.
You didn't know that. Now you do.
Alright. The mouth /anus consume and excrete food. They eat where they poop. Poop where they eat.
Gross.
That's nasty. The
vascular cavity is where the mouth opens into. It's lined with layers of cells called the gastrodermis.
That's where, on the inside of all the tentacles, where we will get to in a minute. The gastrodermis is a layer of cells in the gastrovascular cavity that's on the inside of the mouth.
Is covered with hemotypes and our stinging organs.
That's where they sting their prey, and if you step on one, it stings you.
So don't touch it because it will hurt.